Amen.
We're glad each of you are here tonight. And if you're visiting, we give you a special warm welcome to Oak Grove Baptist Church. And just turn around and greet two or three people. Welcome to the house of the Lord, as this is His house tonight. Kind of reminisce and song and give God the glory. And first we want to think about not forgetting the presence of the Lord, because without His presence we have no hope. And the title of tonight's program is If Ever I Forget. If I'd been a good musician, I would have learned the song, but I want to read you the words and then we'll start the program. Wonderful song, wonderful words. And the Lord said, use this as the theme for tonight. If ever I forget. Listen to these words. You know, sometimes it's hard to be the man you see in me. It's the struggle of this heart, torn between what I should do, between the lies and the truth. How could I fall so far away from a love that takes me as I am and offers a forgiveness that I could never understand? So if ever I forget the one who nailed my shame to a tree, who took my place when no one else believed, you were there for me. If ever I forget the one who gave this heart a second chance, the one who holds my future in His hands, where will I be if ever I forget? Through the fire and the rain, you've been more than just a friend. To this faithless soul, it's beyond my reason why you would stand here by my side. You are the only hope that keeps me going when I'm blinded by my fear. Lord, I found that all I need, I have when you are near. Savior of my life, never let me lose sight of you. Never let me forget.
Yes, I believe.
when you walk through a storm.
God and God alone.
And I hope you're thirsty, and I hope everyone that is thirsty, the scripture says, come to the water, and God will give you an outpouring of His Holy Spirit. In fact, Jesus spoke to a woman at the well who was drawing water, and He said, I will give you water that will last forever. And He said, out of your belly will flow a river of living water that will last forever. And later He explains that's the Holy Spirit of God. Listen to the prophet Isaiah as he says it in words and as I sing it. Ho, everyone that is thirsty. This is our belief. It's been written so beautifully in song. And thank you, Sonny Gale. You'll be back in a little while to play some more. Praise God. Praise the Lord. We thank Brian and Jody and Ashley as they interpret this song. Well, do you believe it?
Amen.
Then stand, and when the time comes for the chorus, or just say, see, I guess it'll be all right. And join with us in seeing God is Holy. This is a kind of a fun song, so we hope you'll have some fun with it. And the Lord wants His people to have fun. You know, when the prodigal son came home, there was music and dancing in the house of the Father. And we want to be joyful in His presence. It's home time. It's coming to the house of the Lord that makes us joyful. God is holy. And we'll do that, and then we'll come back to the other one, okay? So everybody come up with God is Holy. Somehow my music got out of line. There's Karen. Wave your hand. And mother of these five and a few hundred others along the way that we've tried to take care of. And then Catherine, our firstborn. Raise your hand. And married now to Brian Mole. We praise God for him in his ministry also. And then Joshua and Caleb way down there on the end. And Hannah and Lydia. Raise your hand. Okay. Somebody might not know who all of you are. God is holy. Turn the lights on.
Jesus, holy, holy God is holy.
churchy and do the Lord's Prayer, but this is not like most of you ever heard, but this is a wonderful rendition by Michael W. Smith and Joshua on the drums and Caleb and Catherine singing the Lord's Prayer by Michael W. Smith. Here.
Thank you.
This is an old, wonderful song that is old only to those who have just heard it in the last few years, but the thought of it has been there for many years. Many songs talk about being anchored to Jesus Christ, and Ray Bolt's put it together in such a wonderful way, the anchor holds.
I have fallen on my knees.
favorite poems I've shared here 3 or 4 times in recent years is the one I always use before this wonderful gospel song by the Gaithers. It really is true, although it's such a silly little poem. I found it in Decision Magazine probably 15 years ago or longer. It's very simple. I was a nut. I was a nut in a lonely shell till Jesus cracked my shell and salted me and tossed me to a hungry world to make it thirsty for himself. The old rugged cross made the difference. be said about that.
Amen.
If you've had the blood of Jesus Christ to touch you and walk away without any change in your life, something's wrong. But let the blood of Jesus Christ come and cleanse your heart, your life, your family, the church, your career. The blood of Jesus Christ can cleanse us from all our sin.
Amen.
It can even cleanse our nation in the times in which we live today. Well, Jesus didn't stay dead. He didn't stay in the tomb. He arose. And this next song is a favorite we've done several times in this community and in this church. But it has the message so much that Jesus was in the tomb for my sins and your sins. He died on the cross. He was buried. But one day the Father said to His beloved Son, "Arise, arise, my love."
As they guarded the grave. One day, 2 days, 3 days had passed. Could it be that Jesus had breathed His last? Could it be that His Father had forsaken Him, turned His back on His Son, despising our sin? Just forget him, he's dead. Then the Father looked down to His Son and said, "Arise, my love, arise, my love. Reign no longer as a home on you. No more this thing.
case you haven't got the message, Caleb has it in a fresh song that's been out for several years. You want a drink of water with everybody? You've been pretty, can see I'm pretty strong over there. Praise God. This is taken from Scripture, Galatians 2:20. It says, I am crucified with Christ, yet I no longer live. You know the rest of it, but Christ liveth in me. And the life which I now live, I live by the faith and the grace that God gives. Crucified with Christ. Caleb will sing this, and following that, there will be a fantastic portrayal of what God has done in my life and your life if you've been born again. Jennifer Cornett will come, and she will mime and dance about the grace of God when mercy touched the sinner's life.
I chose to be, and to think I know what really.
Merciful eyes.
God.
Amen.
If you have not experienced the mercy of God, the grace of God, then why not let it happen tonight?
Hallelujah.
We have five beautiful young women who have tasted of the grace of God, who have experienced the power of God's forgiveness, His transformation power. And God has blessed them so much. Please welcome Mercy, Melody, McKay, Rhonda Crump, Sarah Ellis, Yvonne Goss, and Laura Heffernan.
His beloved. He refers to her, you and me, in Song of Songs, as the Rose of Sharon. The Rose of Sharon. A rose by any other name just isn't sweet. He is our friend. Amen. We have in Jesus.
Oh, what peace.
Well, we've been talking about not forgetting what God has done. First, we said tonight, if ever I forget the Lord's presence, and we talked about the Lord and His involvement in our lives. This last section was, if ever I forget the Lord's grace, and hopefully you have experienced the grace of the Lord Jesus Christ. For by grace are we saved through faith, not of works, lest any man should boast. It's a free gift of God. And once you become a child of God, the Lord proves His faithfulness. If ever I forget the Lord's faithfulness, Sonny Gale will come and play beautifully on the piano. He's been faithful. From various valleys of the shadow of death, God has delivered our dear sister, and we praise God for how He has marvelously healed her and restored her. He's been faithful, hasn't He?
Amen.
Amen. Praise God.
Thank you.
son. Amen. Has he been faithful in your life?
Amen.
Praise the Lord. Well, this is where I believe that God's going to do something from this moment on in the service for somebody special or whatever. And I want you to believe that God will do something especially for you, for your family, for your church, wherever you go to church. But this is the night that God wants to make things right.
Amen.
Between you and Him and within the body of Christ. This is the night. Tonight, as we were gathering in this church in one accord, I felt His holy presence as we began to praise the Lord. And when I looked where you were sitting, and I gazed into your face, I could see that you were struggling. I could sense your pain, and so I prayed, O Holy Spirit, may your glory fill this place, reveal to those who have a need your answers are.
Your healing in Jesus' name. diseases, your sickness and your pain. Because he'll break the chains that bind you, and he'll cast them away. So while the power of God is flowing, rise up and proclaim, I'm healed, I've been delivered, it's in Jesus' name. This is the night when miracles can happen. This is the night when the blind
next psalm says, my life is in your hands. The words of the chorus on the back. And we hope you'll sing with us. My life is in your hands. You don't have to worry. You don't have to be afraid. Joy comes from morning. Sing with us. Don't walk out, but stand up and sing. My life is in your hands. You don't have to worry. You don't have to be afraid. Joy comes in the morning. From the beginning.
You don't have to worry. And don't you be afraid. Joy comes in the morning. Troubles always, for there's a friend named Jesus who will wipe your tears away. And if your heart is broken, just lift your hands and say, oh, I know that I can make it. I know that I can stand.
Can you believe it?
This song comes from the scripture in Ephesians chapter 3 where Paul prays for the Christians there at Ephesus. And he says that he bows on his knees before God the Father, from whom every family in heaven and earth, every family on earth is named. Thanks, Josh. With Jesus, I can make it. Okay, I'm gonna just hold the microphone. I was gonna do a little mime, maybe I can do it one-handed. But this song talks about, it's the prayer that Paul prayed for the Ephesians. He said he bowed on his knees before the God from whom every family on earth is named, and he prayed that they would know what is the width and the length and the breadth and the depth of the love of Christ, which surpasses all understanding. And he prayed that they would be filled with all the fullness of God. So this song is called The Love of Christ.
The height of the crown.
I know the width and the length and the height and the depth of the love of Christ which surpasses all understanding.
How wide and how long, how high, how deep is the love, how deep is the love of Christ. Oh, how wide and how long, how high, how deep is the love, how deep is the love of Christ. Oh, how wide and how long, how high, how deep is the love of Christ.
Loved us enough to pay for our sins on the cross.
Praise God. Blossom, come on up and play the piano for us and play our offertory. We're going to skip here and come back, and after the offertory we'll have this group Remember Jonah. So we praise God that Blossom has been faithful to serve the Lord all these years in this church, and we have done concerts in many churches in various counties around here, and the Lord's been so good, and every time we sing a concert, we try to do it for a cause or for a purpose, and I was praying about this particular concert, and we don't do it for ourselves, we do it for the Lord, but we want to also encourage you to be a part of a ministry that you may not be a part of. Consuelo York, who has been a missionary for some time with Youth with a Mission, went over to Africa on part of her trip with the Anastasis Mercy Ship. And she adopted a little black boy from Ghana. And the Lord's called him to El Paso, Texas. Our church supports them. Some of you may support her and her son. And so the offering tonight that is received will go directly to Consuelo York and her son Eric. Hope you give a generous offering. And if you want to make a check, make it out to Youth with a Mission. Just Youth with a Mission. And we'll send it directly to them, and they'll make sure it gets to Consuela. And just think about it as Blossom plays this offertory. Just pray about it and then give a generous offering to Consuela York and her son, Eric.
This offertory has been especially selected for this wonderful, talented family that we have been enjoying tonight. I'll tell you, when I get to the chorus of, "This is my story, this is my song," well, I think about the Oliver family. Because no matter what, they are praising their Savior.
Amen.
All the day long.
Amen.
going to hear from Remember Jonah, and then we're going to skip down to 2 or 3 to end with, to Midnight Crying, and I Bowed on My Knees and Cried Holy. And we hope that you will experience the Lord's faithfulness in your life, as we are told through the group that's coming on, Remember Jonah, that God gives us more, abundantly more than we could ever hope for.
Amen.
And also we will anticipate the Lord's coming in the song Midnight Cry, and also the Lord's glory, and I Bowed on My Knees and Cried Holy. Joshua is in this group, back on the drums. And Josh, do you have a mic back there? Since you're the home person, you've got to introduce these guests and welcome to the house of the Lord. Joshua has been in this group, and they've all gotten together, and they have another member or two, but they've just recorded a CD. And introduce everybody. They're still recording it.
On bass, we have Jeff Dolan. And singing tonight is Robbie Blackwell, and Phil Rout songs on piano.
Welcome.
Caleb's got a special guest over here on the top.
This song was written at Phil's house, and we put the finishing touches here at this church, as a matter of fact. And the song expresses our will to serve the Lord, and we hope to please Him tonight. And
And I hope you sense the presence of the Lord in that music and pray for them as they complete an album. It'll be out sometime maybe this summer or in the fall. And they need to be commended. Another reason, because they got up at 6:30 this morning or earlier and traveled to Jacksonville to record some of their album. And they went to Kinston, I believe, and did a concert or so this afternoon. And they drove here and set up their equipment and let the Lord use them tonight. So let's praise the Lord for Remember Jonah. Well, did you hear that phrase in their song that they wrote called I Want God to Be More Than a Pick-Me-Up? Did you get that? That's what a lot of people just consider Jesus to be, a quick fix, pick-me-up. And he needs to be more, amen?
Amen.
Well, I agree with that song wholeheartedly. But there will be a time when he will pick me up.
Amen.
As big as I am, as big as you are, or as good as you are. It's called The Great Coming of the Lord, The Rapture of the Lord. And no better song expresses it than Midnight Cry. And we trust that you are ready for the Lord's coming. Don't forget the Lord is coming. Praise God. We are glad to be here tonight. Brian, that was a wonderful song. I didn't say anything, but that was so touching. We're so blessed to have the gifts that we have. And whatever gifts you have, whether it's singing or playing or cooking or sewing or painting or scrubbing or fixing an engine, whatever it is, use it for the glory of the Lord. For the Lord is coming soon. Let's get the world ready. Let's get the church ready first.
Everywhere.
Yes, I see prophecies fulfilling and the signs of the times
are appearing everywhere. I can almost see the Father.
To him in prayer and intercession. Next Saturday night in this very place at 8 o'clock and on the following Sunday morning at 10 o'clock, we're going to experience the glory of the Lord in a wonderful musical pageant talking about the book of Revelation, the unveiled hope, Jesus, the King, who's coming to make it all right. I hope you'll be back next week and just bring a number of friends. We're not trying to take you from your church or from your fellowship. We just want to share the truth that Jesus is coming back. The unveiled hope is at hand.
Amen.
And it's been prophesied and preached and taught and testified. Jesus is ready to step out on the clouds.
Amen.
And call his children home. And one day we will be there in glory. And the first person we want to see is Jesus Christ.
Amen.
Girls, y'all come up and sing with us, okay?
Welcome.
I dreamed of a city called glory. It was so bright and so fair. When I entered the gates of that city, the angels all met me there.
They carried me from mansions to mansions, and all the sights I saw. But I said, I want to see Jesus, the one who died for me.
I bowed on my knees and cried, oh,
Luke and Timothy.
They're all there. This closing song is an old favorite, and we just decided to throw it at the end here. We hope you'll sing with us. You're my brother, you're my sister. You're taken by the hand, and we will stand for Jesus until he comes. Just play it, and we'll sing with the tape there. And everyone, be sure to greet one another and let each other know who you are if you don't know each other. And let's be prepared to stand for Jesus Christ in Carter County.
Amen.
Words of the soul.